Welcome to the presentation on Engineering Graphics, Unit Number 3, Orthographic Projections. So, in this presentation, we are going to see few more problems of orthographic projections. So, in this case now, this is the pictorial representation of an object, and you are asked to draw the three views of this object by first angle method of projection. Okay, so we are going to observe this particular object from for the front view from this direction. So this is the direction of viewing this object for getting the front view, and for top view you have to look from the top side. So let us try to draw first of all the front view of and then we'll draw the top view of this object. So first we'll draw the xy line. So xy line will be drawn initially, which is a reference line. So front view by first angle method will be above xy line and the top view will be below the xy line. So if you observe this object, now you will find that there is one line here, this particular point and this base point. So when you are looking from this side, actually you will get a vertical line here, straight vertical line. So if you are drawing one line above the xy line by some distance, okay, and below the xy line at the same distance, so that we can draw the front view of it. So whatever the size is of this particular object is there, so we have to draw, we have to find out first of all the height of this object. Okay, so this is our height of it and the width of this object. So width can be obtained from this. Okay, so this is the width of this object. So by knowing this height and width, now we can decide to draw the front view. So if I mark the width of this object like this and the height of this object like this, okay, so this is nothing but the this line which is visible to us on this side. Now here if I see, if I'm looking on this side, so this is the point which is visible to me and this point is there, which is actually on the right hand side. So I will be using this and these two lines, these two points, this point and this point, and I will join this line. So I will get it like this. Similarly, I am getting this one more line because this is a triangle actually. So from the front, I will be in a position to see this one triangle, okay, from the front side, and this triangle. So these two triangles will be visible to me. So for this triangle of this end point and this end point, so I have got this vertical line here using these two, and this end point and this end point of this line, so I have got this another line of it. Now from the same point again one more line is passing of this particular triangle and it's having its base over here. So I have to measure the distance of this point, okay, from here and mark that distance here. Okay, and then we can join these two points. So this way will be the front view of this particular object will be completed. So in short, you will get the front view of this object completed like this. So whatever the size is given to you, according to that it will be drawn over here. Now we have to draw the top view of it. So for top view, you will observe this object from the top side. So in the top view, you will have some dimension of that object which can be included in a particular rectangle. So whatever the size of this rectangle is there, so we have seen here this is nothing but the width of it, okay, and this is nothing but the height. But in the top view we do not require the width, but we need the length. So this can be a length, or we can call this as a least as a width and this as a length, whatever. So actually when you are drawing the front view, so this is actually the length and this is the width. So accordingly we can put the dimensions. And now we will observe that this end point over here looking from the top and this end point, so whatever the line will be joining these two points, so those two points are here, this one and this one, okay, so we will be joining this line. Okay, similarly this point and this line, this point having this complete line visible to me on the top. So this is that line drawn. After that, up to this, there is another line which will be drawn by putting a particular distance. Similarly, from this side, there is another line will be drawn like this. After that, from this point to this point, I will be looking from the top, so I will see, I can see that one more line will be like this. And similarly, from this to this point, okay, there will be one more line like this. And at the same time, this point and this point will be joined by a line. So this I will draw like this. Similarly, this point and this point will be joined by a particular line, and also this point and this point will be joined by a line. So your top view will become like this. So whatever the dimensions are there, that you can put it over there on this particular view. Okay. Now we will see one more object. So this is the pictorial representation of a given object. So we have to observe this particular object from the front. So this is the direction of viewing for the front view. This is the direction of viewing for the top view, and this is the direction of viewing for the side view of this object. So first we will draw the xy line and x1 y1, and we will keep certain distance above xy line and below xy line and towards left and towards right of this x1 y1 line. So now whatever the size of this object is there, so first we have to draw the front view of it. So for getting the front view, we will be drawing the size of this object. So in the front view we need two dimensions. One is the length and the height. So first we have to find out the length and height of this object and just draw a block. Similarly, for getting the top view, we have to draw the length and the width of that particular object. And similarly, we can transfer these dimensions to get the side view. So for transferring this, just you have to draw the projection line from here, and the projection line will be drawn like this. So we can just put your compass here. So these are the center, or if you have to turn it from this side, so we can draw an arc like this, and similarly another arc like this, and then we can extend this line upward so that the width of the object will be transferred, and as well as the length of this object will be transferred by drawing position from this side. Actually, I am drawing all the lines are by freehand, but we have to draw it by using the proper scale. This is just for the explanation purpose. I am using the freehand drawing. Okay. So what are the other details are there of this? You have to again transfer it like this only by drawing the arc with this other center. Okay. So in this object, what I can see from the front, so this portion will be visible to me on the front side. Whenever I am observing this object from the front side, I can see this portion which I am marking here with a blue line now. So all these things will be visible to me in the front view. Okay, so this shape. Okay, so I have to draw this shape in the front view, as well as this portion will be visible to me in the front view, and this shape. So this is the portion which will be visible to me in the front view, as well as this rib will be visible to me in the front view. So accordingly I have to construct it. So definitely whatever may be the height of it, so total this line will be continuous, will be visible to me. Then even horizontal line, this will be also completely visible to me. And then this rightward line is also completely visible to me. So this line will be there, this line will be there, and this line will be there. Let me draw with a black color now that. So this is completely visible to me. Okay, this is also completely visible to me, and this is also completely visible to me. Now for the bottom construction, so there will be some length over here, then there is an upward motion of it, or upward line is there, then again horizontal line. Similarly from this side also, there is a horizontal line, then vertical line, and then again horizontal line like this. and here you will find out this particular arc is there, so half circle is there, so that we have to draw the half circle by considering the center line of it, a long line, short dash line. Forget the center of this particular point and then we can draw this arc. So this is the arc to be drawn. At the same time, when you are going to have this length with you, we can draw it like this. Okay, and again another circle will be there with this kind of shape of it, and inside this again there is a oblong hole like this, so from both sides is curved, and it will look like this. So there is a rib at the top, so this rib will be visible like this. Okay, so this is what is the portion, and now you will find that on the back side of it there is a slot, so the hidden line for this projection will be there throughout. So this will be a hidden line like this, you will get it. Similarly, the hidden line on this side will be there for that this slot, for this point and for this point, two hidden lines vertical downward. So this is what is the shape of this object will be obtained, and similarly we can draw the side view of it looking from this side. So you will get this L shape visible to you in the side view. So this L shape will be visible, which I'm marking with a red color. Similarly, this portion will be there, and this rib, side view of this rib will be visible too on the left hand side. Okay, and all other things which are not visible, that will be shown by the hidden lines. So first what I have to do is, I have to draw these lines dark, which are visible to be completely. Then this line and this line will be matching. So this point will be there at certain distance, it means nothing but here, and from here I have to draw a line, inclined line up to this point. So for that actually I have to take the projection of it. So if I take the projections here, I will get a line like this, and this inclined line like this, and this vertical again here. So this way actually there will be a side view, and in the top view whatever the things which are visible to me, that will be this portion, this C type of shape at the top. This rib is also visible, this shape is visible, this shape is visible. Okay, and this side is also visible to me in the top view. So for that I have to make the proper construction. So I will see that this line continues again, this is downward, this is continuous, so I will get this width completely visible to me in the top view. Okay, similarly this line is continuous, so that will be also visible to me as a continuous line like this. Then this is also continuously visible to me, so it will be there. Now there is some portion horizontal, and then this part where that construction we have to complete. So we can take the positions from here, so for that slot, this slot will be visible like this, this way. Okay, now this rib will be there, so you can take the positions from this rib, and it will be drawn like this, and this will be the construction for the rib. Okay, so this you have drawn C shape. So first we will, let us complete that C shape. Actually it will be like this only. Okay, and there is no portion here, this is, I am just making it dark. So this C shape, actually there should not be such kind of provision for that, making it dark. But I don't want these two lines, therefore I have drawn it like this. So this section will be a C shape section, this rib visible, and this side and this side. Okay, now all other thing details means there is a groove inside this circular, so for that there will be dotted lines here inside it. That projections you can take it from here, also from here, for that, like this. Okay, so in total these three views, after making proper lines, straight lines, if you draw it properly, the front view, top view and the side view will look like this. This is the front view, this is the side view, left hand side view, and this is the top view. Okay, so actually this rib and this dimension, if it is matching, in that case that dotted line or the hidden line will not be visible, because it is matching with this slot. So this rib and just exactly below this there is a hand line, means this for this will be the projection. But this slot which is there, this one and this one, these two lines that are visible over here, this one and this one. Okay. While for this this slot is already there. Okay, so there is no other hand lines are there. So thank you. We'll just stop here.